Good morning, children. Today's subtopic is transportation from the lesson Life Process. Today we are going to learn about blood, secondly about heart, third blood vessels, fourth point circulation in humans, and lastly it is about limb. Okay, children, one small question to you all. Why are human red blood cells biconcave in shape? I repeat the question. Why are human red blood cells biconcave in shape? I think you know the answer. I'm going to say because they are biconcave in shape because they have maximum surface. Biconcave, you know, children. Maximum surface so that they can carry more oxygen and also they can squeeze into the blood capillaries. I repeat the question, why are red blood cells biconcave in shape? The answer is to get more maximum surface area so that they can carry more oxygen in them and also they can squeeze into the blood capillaries. Squeeze means moving inside the capillaries. Got it, children? Okay, moving forward, we are going to learn about about transportation. Now, in the last earlier classes, we learnt nutrition and respiration. Let us recall what we have learnt in our earlier class. Okay, in nutrition, we learned that the purpose of digestion means food is converted into more absorbable form so that blood can be absorbed, isn't it? Or else that is nothing but complex food is broken down or it is converted into simpler form so that blood can be absorbed. Why blood? Why blood should be absorbed? So that it can be transported to all parts of the body. Got it? It can be transported. Blood. Blood is very, very important one. So conversion of complex food into simple absorbable form. I think we have seen in villi. In villi, digestion in the digestion process, we come across villi. Villi contains more blood capillaries so that blood can absorb food and takes to all parts of the body. Okay, children. So there also we come across blood. In respiration, moving on to respiration, we have seen that in lungs, lungs contain alveoli. They are the air sacs. Isn't it? It contains, alveoli contains more blood vessels. Here, more blood vessels and even food and oxygen also should be supplied to all parts of the body. So here, who is transporting oxygen and glucose to all parts of the body? It is nothing but blood. Got it, children? Glucose is coming into the blood. Oxygen also is coming into the blood. Now we shall learn how this oxygen and glucose are transported throughout our body. Okay, children, moving on, that our body requires glucose and oxygen for the production of energy. We have seen in respiration in the earlier class. The cell uses oxygen to break and the glucose to produce energy. Okay, then, that is what we call it as respiration. Very good, children. Okay, then, why do we need blood? Why do we need blood? Isn't it? Because we need blood because it transports, blood transports glucose and oxygen. Nothing but food or glucose. Food and oxygen. Isn't it? Food and oxygen and carbon dioxide and waste materials in our body. Not only food, oxygen, carbon dioxide and waste materials also. Waste materials also in our body. Okay, children. So it is called as an efficient system. Efficient system in our body. Because blood, it not only carries food, oxygen, carbon dioxide it is removing, and even waste materials from our body. So it is considered as efficient system. Got it, children? Efficient system in our body. Okay, children, now let us imagine our heart. Okay, our heart, I think you all know, heart is like, we'll say a pump, which pumps water. We'll take a pumping machine. Just, we'll imagine, just we have put one pumping machine down to our building. It is like a water pump, or children, in our body. Heart is like, how we'll say for a building, how the pump will be there, where water will be supplied to that entire building. Same here, this heart is supplying blood to all parts of our body. Okay, we imagine. Now we'll see, we have many pipes to a house. For a house, we have many pipes, isn't it? Same. Even to our body, we have many pipes. There are many pipes in our body system. As many pipes are blood vessels. They are nothing but what? Blood vessels. That pipes are. Suppose we take, this is an house. We have number of pipes, isn't it? I told you, that is nothing but, that pipes are nothing but blood vessels. It means in our blood, there are so many pipes, so that blood fluid flows in that, in our pipes, how water flows. In that example, same in our body, through these blood vessels, a fluid flows, that is nothing but blood. There are so many and they will be flowing in them. Just like we have a pump down the building, it pumps the water into the tank. Same here, how that pump will pump the water into the tank, same our heart also will pump the blood into the, our body. Throughout the body. Okay, moving forward, what is blood? Now a question arises for us, then what is blood, isn't it? We considered, and now what is blood? What it is made up of? What is blood made up of? We have a question, isn't it? Okay, blood consists of two things. That is plasma and blood cells. First one is plasma, and secondly, it contains blood cells. Okay, children, 55% of the blood is plasma. How much percent? 55% of our blood is plasma. And 45% is blood cells, children. Got it? Now I'll give you one example. Okay, children, let me take one water bottle, you imagine. We'll take one water bottle. In that water bottle, I'll just add up water to it. Just I'll put on water to it. I add little red sand to it, a little blue sand to it, a little white sand to it. Got it, children? I have taken water bottle. I have added, I put water to it. Next I added red sand to it. Next I added blue sand to it and white sand. Isn't it, children? Now you can see water, red sand, blue sand and white sand. Isn't it? The bottle in which water is poured, that is plasma, nothing but plasma. Then what is the red sand? Red sand is nothing but RBC. red blood corpuscles. Then what are blue sand? Blue sand is WBC. Blue sand is WBC and white sand is platelets. Got it, children? First I have taken water bottle. I poured water to it. I added red sand, that is nothing but RBC. Blue sand I added, that is WBC. I added even white sand, they are platelets. Now we'll see each one of function of RBC, WBC and platelets, children. Okay, children. What is their function?
RBC, WBC.
Then, now we'll see what is the function of RBC. The function of RBC is to transport gases. Got it, children? The function of RBC is to transport gases. Then what is the function of platelets? Children, you know, clotting of blood is the function of platelets. Then what is blood clotting? I think by accidentally we get a hurt, or suddenly when you are cutting some fruits or vegetables, suddenly we get a cut on our hand or a finger. Then we see blood coming out of our body. After few minutes, the blood will stop. We see blood stopping, isn't it? This is because of platelets. This is called as blood clotting. The blood will clot there. First it was flowing, after that it clots, isn't it? Who is helping? The work of platelets. Now we'll go for white WBC. Then what is the work of WBC? WBC is responsible for immunity. I think you are familiar nowadays. They are responsible for our immunity. They are the one who are giving protection for us. I think at the time of corona, now the crisis, WBC are protecting us from that coronavirus, isn't it? Because we won't get, up to now we did not receive the vaccine. So children, it is the one who is acting as a soldier in our body by protecting our body, not to give entry to the foreign particles, means that virus to come inside our body, is the work of WBC. Got it, children? Okay, children. So WBC are very, very important as they are giving protection to our body. Okay, children. Then what is this plasma? The water which I poured into the bottle is nothing but plasma, isn't it? These three particles, children, plasma is the fluid in which all these three cells, WBC, RBC and platelets, are suspended in that plasma fluid. Okay, children? And these are, I think, once again I repeat, it also contains, which are suspended or floating in plasma. These three the cells are floating in the blood. Now we see, not only in plasma, we come across 90% of plasma is water. Only some very less percentage, like proteins and some ions and glucose, etc., are present in that plasma. Okay, children. Now we have learnt about blood, as it contains plasma and blood cells. In that blood cells, we come across RBC, WBC and platelets. And even we have learnt what is the function of RBC, what is the function of WBC and what is the function of platelets. Here it transports gases. It acts as an shoulder, isn't it? It protects our body. Thirdly, it helps in clotting of blood. Now, okay, children, even now we come across, now we go for heart, children, which is very, very, very important. Before we are going to heart, let us learn about blood vessels. Got it, children? Blood vessels. There are three types of blood vessels. Firstly, they are arteries. Second one, it is veins. Third one, it is capillaries. Okay, children, blood vessels contain are of three types. They are arteries. Second one is veins. Third one, it is capillaries. Children, now let us take one example. Now, I'll say that we have one building, a house or a building. We have many pipes to a house, isn't it, children? Now, let us take one example that to a house, we need fresh water pipelines. Even we need some pipelines which carry our waste also, even drainage system and fresh water pipelines also we need is for a house. Same. So, now the building is considered as our body. The fresh water pipelines are called as the one which carries fresh blood or water are called as arteries. Got it, children? Arteries are the one which supply or which pass clean and oxygen-rich blood to the body. Then waste material also. Garbage will be there in our house, isn't it? We waste water that should be drained out from our house. That is impure one is taken out by veins. Got it, children? Waste going out of the building are nothing but veins. Okay, children. Now we'll see what is the function of the arteries and veins in detail. Arteries is giving pure blood to the organs. That is oxygen rich blood to the organ. Who is carrying out? Arteries. But whereas veins are taking away waste. I told you waste, no? Taking away carbon dioxide mixed blood from the organs. From the organs it is coming. To the organs it is supplying. This is coming out from the organs. Taking away from the organs to where? To lungs. For purification. Got it, children? Then what are capillaries? Now I have told you, fresh water pipelines are called as arteries. Impure, the waste ones are called as veins. Then what about capillaries? Capillaries, in my building, there are various places where I can use water. Isn't it? In kitchen, I want one tap. In bathroom, I want one tap. In wash basin, I want one tap. Then, wherever I want that tap, I can have that. I can use that water. Isn't it? I can use that water. So, that is the work of capillaries. We can use the capillaries or the site of exchange between cells and the organs and the blood. Wherever I need water, I can turn the wall and I can take the water, use the water. Isn't it? That is the capillaries. The capillaries take up the oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. Then where does it happen? It happens in the cells. Where are the cells then? The cells are in the tissues or in the organs. Got it? So capillaries are thin tubes which are site of exchange. These capillaries are thin tubes where exchange takes place. Got it, children? Next, in my next class, I'll be telling you about how to draw heart and what are the functions of human heart. Okay, got it, children? I'll show you how to draw heart, easy way of drawing heart in the next class, and I'll be explaining for you about the functions of the heart, children. Okay, children, thank you.